Bill, there are a lot of elements at work in this French musical picture clock. Can you walk us through it?
Yes. So I think 98% of the people, they saw this in our gallery, they would automatically assume that the part at the bottom is a painting. And it is, but it's more than a painting. And whereas we call this a clock, the clock is almost the most insignificant part of it. Whereas, you know, the clock, which we just spoke about, was so, the movement was so important. This clock is just part of the decoration. Now, I want to give you a grasp of this size. This is roughly, I'm guessing, 42 inches wide, maybe 40 inches wide, and maybe 46 or 48 inches high. That's big. And it's something that's extraordinary. I think the next picture shows the inside, if I'm not mistaken. Oh no, this is close-ups. And you can see them, you know, to see them making the horseshoes and putting the horseshoe on the left. In the back, you can see the bay with the women washing and, you know, man fishing. We can go to the next picture. This is the movement. So this is the clock. That's the music box on the bottom right, which plays music. And those round things are the chimes. So it has different chimes that would dong, ding, dong, you know, depending on the hour. So this is a clock that, this is a painting that sat on your wall. And then the clock would strike whatever hour it was, 10 o'clock. And I'll show you what will happen. So hopefully you can hear me over the music. You can see they're hammering and they're making the horseshoes, they're putting the horseshoe on. Look at the man on the right. He's actually doing the bellows for the fire. He's pulling it. The man on the left, he's putting the horseshoe on. The dog's wagging its tail. In the back, the women are rubbing the clothes against rocks. It is just the most extraordinary thing when you see, because it shocks you, because it's all three-dimensional. You see the windmill all the way on the left and the water wheel also in the middle and the back. It has so many moving parts that you don't even notice. The horse head moves on the left, which you don't see right there. Now you see it. It's just, it's awe-inspiring. It came from one of the great collectors in the world, a gentleman by the name of Larry Claremont. Many people in Chicago know who he is, the Claremont Coin Car Museum. Larry was a Iwo Jima, a veteran, hero of the war, and he lived to be 96 or so. And we bought this from his collection. It's just as extraordinary as one will ever see.